Yeah. I don't know. I guess I never really did apologize about that perpetual. Oh my god, there it goes. My perpetual motion fail. I didn't really get into that. The one that was on the wheels, it was on the downhill mimicker. It just didn't work. I talked to my professor. What is he? First cousin? No. Yeah. Oh, I don't know what he is. An uncle? No. He is a first cousin once removed or something. Yeah, I talked to him. And I'm like, well, it works, you know, and he's like, no, it doesn't. He understood my principle of it, but I guess there's a law factor, a factor of stop law, and it was at this stop law that it fails. So, but I'm still like, well, what about the ramp idea? You know, you have the rolling ramp underneath it. You know, you have the wheels of the initial car on top and then the rolling ramp underneath. It just keeps rolling, you know, just like a track, a rolling track. And I'm like, well, maybe that one? You know. But he's pretty old guy and he can't, you know, he just remembers his algorithms that he learned. And for that one, he didn't have the answer. So as much as a physics professor as he's been in his life, that one... he wasn't ready for it. He didn't actually have the algorithm mathematical in his head. So I'm still pending on that one. I still think it exists. But so, yeah. Anyway, I have to. And I was cute. I really did try the prototype. I got the little car. I tried the roller thing. I made a little prototype, and then I just gave up on it. It was sad. So my downhill mimicker died, and then I still am on the ramp, the ramp things. So anyway, or the conveyor belt underneath the car, that thing that just keeps like underneath it. But anyway. Yeah, that the wheels, the car wheels itself, roll the conveyor belt, and it's such a time sequence that they don't roll off the conveyor belt, they stay on the conveyor belt, but it all goes, probably it will be some kind of algorithm that says no, or anyway, so I made. This last week, though, back to spreadsheet world, and that is working for me somewhat. I'm not ecstatic with the PMI formulas, the payment and interest formulas that they have out there that go into the sheets, these Excel sheets. I find they can be a little precarious in the out numbers they're giving. They're not exact. Like, I wanted a drawdown of a certain amount. And it wouldn't give it that certain amount. It was giving like 20%, 25% less. So it was showing payments less than I wanted to actually have applied toward the principal. It was giving less in the 30-year time frame or in the 20-year time frame. So I don't know. That's another thing I have to go seek out in the land of Excel. And normally. And then I'm like, well, maybe it's because I added too many of them in one sheet, one workbook, and when you add too many, then the whole workbook just says, uh-uh, I don't want to add math any longer, and so it could be that. But anyway, it's a really cool one, and I don't really want to give it away. It's that great. It's a retirement portfolio, and what it does is it tells you, like, let's say you have... an IRA. Let's say you have savings. Let's say you have, from your checking account. Let's say you have, like, stocks. Let's say you have sale from your house. You're planning on selling your house. So all of these events, they happen at all different times as we're retiring. And so that makes it kind of like, what an annoyance, because you never really can find out, you know, how much am I going to be making when I'm 65, really? How much am I going to have when I'm 70, or how much when I'm 55? And so I tried to fix all of this. And so I've made all of these little, these columns, and I have them all sorted out, and then there it is. And so it'll tell you at what age, and the Social Security is included. All of those windfalls, and even inheritance, if you got that. So all of those tantrias. And then I also included, just to make life fun, because we still exist in this retirement, the inclusion to add money back in. So let's say you got an inheritance. Well, let's say you don't want to just, you want to take that, and you want to withdraw little by little out of it, but yet you may want to still add things into it, you know what I mean? You still might want to add money into those accounts, and so I left places for that, so you can still add money to increase it while you're waiting to draw down, because maybe you don't want to draw down from that account for 10 years. Or maybe you decided, that account I'll only start drawing down in 5 years from now. So that's what I did. I made each one of those different weird things that happen in your retirement future. You can set them at different retirement drawdown times. So you can turn on the button for that IRA at a certain time in your life. And you can turn, and for a specific number, a specific amount. So at the end of the day, you know, you can really plan if you want 3,000 or you want 1,000 every month, or if you want 40,000, whatever you are, you know, whatever you're doing. I guess some of you would want to blow it right away, but others are not. You know, some want to be very, very secure all the way through to their 100. The only drama I had with it was, my gosh, mine was hysterical. Mine's hysterical, and can I do it? I don't know if I can survive off of it, but it is a challenge, that is for sure. It is a challenge. But yeah, so as far as retirement portfolio management goes, woo-wee, I made a really cool one. But yeah, I don't really want to give it away. So it's kind of selfish of me right now. Anyway. What's that thing? Oh yeah, Merry Christmas to everybody.